today, we've got some tricks from the Tarbell course in magic.
Volume, mate. That is coming up.
Tricks here, doing tricks for you with these lovely chickens to make your world a little bit more interesting. But today I've got some tricks from the last volume of the Tarbell course in magic, volume 8. Looking forward to showing you some tricks out of this. These first couple of effects, we're going to get straight into it from the chalk talk section of this book, and they're pretty good. I'm not going to say too much about it. Let's get into it and see what you think. This one. Now, we're on lockdown, times are hard. People can't earn the money, but Tarbell course in magic, volume 8 has the answer. All you have is this pad, okay? This pad, ordinary pad. What you do is you just take one piece of paper from the pad, and what we'll do is we'll just take out a pen. This is what you do. You take the pen and you draw what you can see here is in fact a bag. Not the best drawing of a bag in the world, but hey. And then what you do is you just put a sign, a money sign on there like so. Word. Tarbell calls me magic. And you take out a knife. That's not a knife. That's a knife. And you just cut through the bag like so. If you watch, all I've got to do is take this bag, open it up, and look inside. It's actually money. Look at that, 20s, 20 there, 20 there. With this, you can draw your own wages. Look, it doesn't stop there. We've got more, more, more. Look at this, the wages. There's so much, you don't know what to do with it. And that is how you get money. It's amazing. Shh, don't tell anyone. So there you have it. Pretty good tricks, fun to do. I think you'll agree. A nice effect there. The first one with a bit of music, and the second one
It's one way of making a bit of money in these hard times. So keep that one to yourselves. If you've got the book, look it up. Fantastic. It's a money maker. Now these next tricks are from the card section, and I hope you enjoy it. We'll get into these tricks. I'll play them back to back, and I'll see you after. Boyakasha.
Okay, so for this trick, we use this pack of cards, and we're gonna take out four cards, but I'm not just gonna take them out of the pack. I'm gonna use a trick that I learned from the book, The Classic Magic of Larry Jennings. What I'll do is I'll just show you what this effect is. It is a nice reveal of some cards. And all it is, you just take the cards, you can cut the cards like so into four piles like this. Cover the cards with your hand like that, and each ace will magically appear one by one. Now that is revelation from The Classic Magic of Larry Jennings. Now this is the trick from the Tarbell course in magic. All we do is we place three indifferent cards on top of each ace, just like so. Get rid of the rest of the pack, don't need that. Ace of diamonds, ace of hearts, ace of clubs, and of course the last ace of spades. We have three indifferent cards underneath, so one, two, and of course three. The ace of diamonds goes over here. One, two, seven of diamonds, ace of hearts over here. One, two, three, and the ace of clubs over there. And finally, the ace of spades, which goes over there as well. We take all the indifferent cards from here, and we make three piles, just like so. And the spectator can pick any pile they wish. Anyone, completely free choice. Say for instance they pick this pile over here, put it to one side. You show this pile with all indifferent cards. You pick up the next one, all indifferent cards. You take the aces, give them a shake. They also become indifferent cards. And in fact the aces are now all over here, the cards the spectator chooses. Okay, so here's another nice card trick you can use, which requires a spectator. And the spectator can pick a card. You say to the spectator, cut the pile. They cut the pile in the position they want. Remember the card. They remember this card, which is three of diamonds. Place it on the pile over here. They place the pack back on there, square it, and this can all be done with your back turned. Now, they can cut the pile as many times as they like so. You can even give it a mix like this. The card sauce. Now I make some pile of cards and I'll stop whenever I feel like it. I'll stop dealing anytime I wish. I'm gonna stop there. And then I know that their card, the three of diamonds, nice little quick card trick. Okay, so for this effect, pack of cards we use, and in fact, this is a nice quickie. You should say to the spectators, they can select any card they wish. In this case, it is the Queen of Spades. The Queen of Spades is here. You can see the Queen of Spades, and the Queen of Spades will go into the pack. So we'll cut it in like so. A little mix, a little shuffle. The card is lost. And they say, what was your card? He said, the Queen of Spades. I said, if you watch carefully, the cards fly from the pack. In fact, it is the Queen of Spades. Lavish money bag.
So there you have it. A nice ace trick there under the card section in this book. And obviously at the beginning there I showed you revelations from the book The Classic Magic of Larry Jennings, which also you should look up. I think it's a very, very nice visual way of producing some cards. The one in the middle was called A Good Card Trick, which by the way, it's not a mathematical trick and it's not done with marked cards. So you must look at that trick, find that if you've got the book, and I hope you enjoyed it. Chicken's just done a poo. And then the last one, called kickback card, where you just quickly reveal a card, and I think that's really nice as well. So take a look at that. Hope you enjoyed this video. Be sure to subscribe, leave a comment, and definitely smash that like button, because I really appreciate it. And also remember, you press the notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos, because well, they're good fun, and yeah, you might be missing out, and I'll be seeing you in the next one.